हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल लोकल गाय। फ्रेंड्स, नाउअडेज एवरीवन इज यूजिंग वाईफाई। एवरीबॉडी हैज अ वाईफाई राउटर एट होम और ऑफिस फॉर इंटरनेट कनेक्शन। वाईफाई राउटर प्रोवाइड्स ग्रेटर स्पीड देन मोबाइल डाटा, बट वाईफाई राउटर्स हैव सम लिमिटेशंस। वाईफाई प्रोवाइड्स अप्रोक्सीमेट 150 टू 200 फीट रेंज, एंड बिकॉज ऑफ वाईफाई राउटर्स रेंज लिमिटेशन, वी ऑल हैव एक्सपीरियंस वीक वाईफाई सिग्नल और लो स्पीड। Suppose at home you have placed the Wi-Fi router in the drawing room. Wi-Fi signal is strong at the drawing room, but in the bedroom we receive weak signal or sometimes no signal. If you are living in a two-story house and place the Wi-Fi router at ground floor, we cannot receive Wi-Fi signal at first floor. Wi-Fi signal operates at 2.4 GHz and 5 GHz frequency band, so the wavelength of the signal is very small. It's about 12 cm and 5 cm respectively. If our wall thickness is greater than that, it cannot penetrate the thick wall of our house. Even if it penetrates, it loses some energy, it means attenuated, and cannot travel so long distance. To penetrate the wall, it requires more power, but Wi-Fi routers have some standards set. It cannot deliver high power. Low frequency travels longer while high frequency travels shorter. High frequency needs more power to travel longer. 4G mobile network uses frequency band 1800 MHz to 2700 MHz. It means 1.8 GHz to 2.7 GHz. But it delivers high power to the signal, so it can penetrate the wall better. So how to increase our Wi-Fi range so we can receive strong Wi-Fi signal in every corner of the house? Today, I am going to show you how to convert your old Wi-Fi router as a Wi-Fi repeater or Wi-Fi range extender, so don't skip the video and watch till the end. Before starting the video, if you have not subscribed to my channel, then please subscribe first and press the bell icon for new video notification. Friends, you can browse my channel for more useful videos. So what we are going to do is, here is my home Wi-Fi router which is up and running. Its model number is TP-Link TDW8970. Its IP address is 192.168.1.1. Wi-Fi network SSID name is Falcon1 and password is time0000. I have placed this router at ground floor. I have another router which I have placed at first floor and want to convert it as a Wi-Fi repeater or Wi-Fi range extender, so I can receive strong Wi-Fi signal on first floor also. So without wasting time, let's start the video. Friends, here I am using my old TP-Link router, model number WR841N, which is still a best-seller router. You can buy it from the link given in the description, or you can use any other router. Process is the same. First of all, we have to reset the router. Press and hold the reset button. To configure router as a Wi-Fi repeater, we need to log in into the router. All the login information is given at the backside of the router. So first, we have to connect to the router's default Wi-Fi network. You can use your mobile and can do all the settings without using a computer. Here, default Wi-Fi SSID name is TP-Link E0FA and password is 7669379. Now, to access the settings, we need to log in into the router. For that, go to browser and type http://tplinkwifi.net or 192.168.0.1. Enter the username and password as given. Here, it is admin and password is also admin. Now, go to wireless and under wireless settings, you can change the default SSID name or leave it as it is. Here, I am changing SSID name to SpaceX. As we have changed the SSID name, we are disconnected from the default Wi-Fi network SSID. So connect to new Wi-Fi network SSID SpaceX with default password. We have not changed the password yet. To change the default password, go to Wireless and under Wireless Security, change the default password to new one. Here I am changing it to time 1234 and click Save. We are again disconnected from the network. Reconnect with new password. Now go to Wireless Settings. At the bottom, enable WDS bridging. A new settings will open. Here we have to enter SSID name and BSSID name of the router. If you don't know that, then click on Survey. A new window with a list of available Wi-Fi network SSID names will show up. Here my home Wi-Fi network SSID name is Falcon 1 and its channel number is 11. And I want to bridge this router to my home router network. So click on Connect. Our home Wi-Fi router is using channel number 11. So change the channel number from auto to 11. Now you have to enter your home Wi-Fi network password. Leave other settings as it is. My home Wi-Fi password is time 0000. If we set channel auto and because of so many Wi-Fi signals available nearby, our Wi-Fi router changes its channel number frequently to avoid congestion. Or when we reboot the router, then also router changes its channel number. So if the primary main router changes its channel number, repeater or extender router cannot know that and connection between them will be disconnected. So it's better to change the Wi-Fi channel from auto to manual on both the routers and choose the same channel number to avoid network disconnection. So we selected the SSID, BSSID to be bridged, then change the channel number and also enter the password. Now save the settings. Now one more settings we have to do is disable DHCP server. We want our main router as a DHCP server. DHCP server provides IP addresses to all the devices on the network. We cannot use two DHCP server on one network. DHCP settings take effects after rebooting the router. Let's reboot the router. Now this router is wirelessly bridged with our home Wi-Fi router. So this router will act as a Wi-Fi repeater or range extender. Now again connect to this router's Wi-Fi and check if the internet is working or not. And yes, you can see that we can browse the internet with same speed as the main home Wi-Fi router. As I have said earlier, keep the same channel number on both routers. So open the browser and type your main primary router's IP address. If you don't know your Wi-Fi router's IP address, then open command prompt and type ipconfig. On the Wi-Fi adapter, you can find the default gateway. Here it is 192.168.1.1. That is your router's IP address. Login with username and password. Then go to Wireless and change the channel settings from auto to manual and select channel number 11. Now put the router at a place where it will get at least 40% of the main router's Wi-Fi signal. Your Wi-Fi signal will be boosted and you will get a strong Wi-Fi signal with the same speed as the main router in other rooms also. You can use the Wi-Fi Analyzer app from Play Store and can analyze the signal strength of Wi-Fi router and place the router accordingly. Wi-Fi strength up to -50 dBm is considered as excellent signal and Wi-Fi strength above -75 dBm is considered as poor signal. Let's recap what we have done. First, reset the router. Second, login into the router. Third, enable WDS. Fourth, from the available Wi-Fi network list, choose and connect with home Wi-Fi network by entering password. Fifth, change channel from auto to manual and keep same channel number. Sixth, disable DHCP server. Seventh, restart the router. Thanks for watching the video. If you have any query about the settings, please ask me in the comments. Like, share and subscribe to my channel for more videos. Till then, goodbye.